Over the years, humans have mastered the act of making random electrons move in a specified direction. This is usually done through the use of electromagnetic force, or through the use of magnets. In today's series, we will be looking at how electromagnetic inductions work, which is the way in which currents are usually induced in a solenoid coil will be looked at. And finally, this interaction between solenoid coils and a magnetic field will be proven using mathematical equations. That said, let's get started. By definition, electromagnetic induction is the process in which an electromagnetic force is induced in an electric conductor when brought into a changing magnetic field.
So looking at this circuit here, this circuit consists of a coil of wire which is further connected to a galvanometer here, and the magnetic bar that will be used for the experiments is held there. Now, if I should bring this magnetic bar here, and if I bring this bar inside this coil here, the needle of the galvanometer will deflect towards the right here and it will move back to its resting position. And if I should gradually pull the magnet away from the coil, the needle will deflect towards the left and it will gradually return to its resting position.
Again, the rate at which the needle moves has to do with how the magnet is pulled away, or how it is pushed toward the coil.
Likewise, if I should reverse the polarity of the magnetic bar here, and when it is brought very close to the solenoid again, now, unlike before, the galvanometer deflection will be in the opposite direction. That is, when we compare this experiment to the first experiment that was performed earlier.
The same can be said when the source of the magnetism is through an electromagnet. So if I should energize this coil here, and when it is brought very close to the solenoid coil there, the needle of the galvanometer will experience a momentary movement too. Now when we compare the deflection of the needle, it can be seen that the needle displacement is very similar to the first experiment which was carried out using a pure magnetic material.
These experiments that we just carried out now proved Faraday's first law of electromagnetic induction. During that time, Faraday's statement was, whenever there is a change in the magnetic flux linking to a conductor, then electromotive force will be induced in the conductor. And when the circuit is closed, then this electromotive force will produce a current in the conductor.
The experiments that we just performed here can be said to only deal with how electromotive force are induced in a circuit. This is why the needle deflects momentarily and moves back to its resting position.
Now, when I bring this magnetic bar towards this solenoid coil here, and when I move the magnetic bar in and out rapidly within this coil here, this rapid movement of the magnetic bar will induce more current within the circuit.
This second experiment also proved Faraday's second law of electromagnetic induction too. Faraday's second statement then was, the magnitude of electromotive force induced is directly proportional to the rate of change of magnetic flux.
Again, mathematically, the second experiment can further be proved using these mathematical equations here. The instantaneous electromotive force is equal to the change of magnetic flux over the change in time. So in order to have moving current and more electromotive force flowing within the circuit, then it is a function that is tied to the rate at which the coil is cutting the magnetic flux. These experiments here will be handy in the next series. In the next series, we will be looking at mutual inductance and self-inductance. The way electrical circuits react differently to them will be looked at, and their application. Until then, peace.